even get some cross.
What is going on, guys? My name is Joey Orva, DBZ on 123, and we are back with some more Dragon Ball Z for another Dragon Ball Xenoverse discussion. And today, guys, I'm going to run my Platinum TDS, Royalty, and Black Super Saiyan. So I will let them introduce themselves, then we'll kick off this amazing Dragon Ball Xenoverse discussion.
Oh, it's my turn? Oh, what's up, Mavs? It's Platinum TDX and Dragon Streamer. Welcome to another Dragon Ball Xenoverse video.
And it is Royalty from TNK, a.k.a. Suki no Kami Gaming. What it do, guys? All right, that's me. So, Black Super Saiyan.
I don't know who I am, to be honest. You could call me Black Super Saiyan, but I'm making a new channel soon.
I don't know what to call me.
So
I'm gonna call me Black Super Saiyan. You are Black Super Saiyan. Your profile picture, you haven't changed it on Skype yet. You are Black Super Saiyan, and your name is spelled wrong. End of discussion.
I am neither Kami nor Piccolo, dang it.
All right.
He is Kamikolo.
Okay.
All jokes aside, let's kick off
with the video.
I'm with the video. Is Box First thing with the video? Or no? No? Alright, so with all jokes aside, let's kick off this actual Dragon Ball Xenoverse discussion. Now today, you guys, we are going to be talking about DLC Pack 2 and pretty much the stuff that has been confirmed for DLC Pack 2, which is actually some good but not so good stuff. Now with DLC Pack 2, we have a very good data miner, which is Sergio M3. You guys know him, most of you guys do know him, but if you guys don't know him, you guys probably been living underneath a rock for the past 6 months because he has been data mining all that kind of stuff right there. But pretty much in an end of his newest video, he pretty much did explain a couple things about DLC Pack number 2. Now with DLC Pack number 1, it's pretty much the half of the GT story, and DLC Pack 2 is the other half of the GT story, meaning Omega Shenron fight all the Shadow Dragons, Nova Shenron, Ice Shenron, all that kind of stuff right there. Now, with DLC Pack 2, we don't know what the super attacks are, the ultimate attacks are, or the clothes, anything like that. We don't know that. I would imagine that one of them is going to be Ice Shenron's clothes or Nova Shenron's clothes, but we don't know for a fact yet. But with DLC Pack 2, we get two new playable characters that most of us did know, which is pretty much Nova Shenron and Ice Shenron. So, this is actually some pretty good news, but Platinum, what is your overall thoughts on these two characters actually being playable in this DLC pack?
Okay, so Ice Shenron, he's pretty cool. DBZ guy was a fucktard, so I can't remember exactly what I said. Nova Shenron, he hasn't been in a game since Tenkaichi 3, and it's always good to get these guys that are never in a game or always, like, haven't been in the past few games, especially with the past few games having like shitty rosters. It's pretty cool, especially since Nova Shenron, I like his moveset, I like his style. He's like a fiery guy, and Ice Shenron is his ice, yeah, he's his name, yeah. But for me, I'm not really looking forward to the story for the damn thing. I was never looking forward to the story for the DLC packs, at least. After playing the full game, because, I mean, it's DBZ, what are you going to expect? You're not expecting some Last of Us type shit, that's for sure.
Exactly. But, hell no.
Yeah, true.
But, I think my real focus of these GT DLC packs, like these GT themed ones, is where the fuck is my Super Baby?
Right.
Exactly. Even give me Super Baby 2, I'll be fine with that.
No, let me explain. I'm ranting on this, alright? TNK, go first.
Yeah, TNK, go first.
Oh, well, basically, my, same shit that Platinum TDX said, man. It's cool. We haven't seen Nova Shenron since Tenkaichi 3. Ice Shenron's never been in the game. Where the fuck is Super Baby at? I'm done. You can go, Black Super Saiyan.
Alright. So, true, I am a hot nigga. Alright. Alright, here we go. Now, check this, right? Like Platinum was saying, Super Baby still ain't been, like, confirmed in the game at all. And I got a problem with this right here. Right? Like Platinum was saying before DBZ got fucked up the other video. Okay.
I knew you was hitting me.
Alright, so basically, Baby need to be in this game. That's all I'm gonna say. Alright, Baby need to be in this game, and if he ain't in the game, I'ma flip. And when I flip, I flip on the lights, spitting bars all night. Oh my lord! Like, get out my like. Oh, come on now, I'm dead serious right now. But for real though, Baby need to be in this DLC pack too. If he not, that's just another mess up on their part. Like, Nova and Ice Shenron, okay, I'm not gonna play as them, but it don't matter. I'm looking for Baby. Dang on, you know what I'm saying? I need Baby. I mean, even if I just get one form of Baby, like Baby and maybe Super Baby or just Super Baby 2, like in Infinite World, I don't care. I just want Baby to be in this game because he is literally...
Exactly.
He is like the main, like Platinum was saying, he the main nigga in GT. Like,
when people think of man, like, GT, if they're not thinking of Omega Shenron, they're thinking of Baby, not Super 17.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. Exactly.
Like, this man is like the Frieza of GT. Got a reason to hate the Saiyans. He forced the main transformation of the series, Super Saiyan 4. If it wasn't for him, Goku would be dead, man. Like, it's ridiculous that they sit up here and leave out my main nigga. And you know what the funny thing about it is? You know what the funny thing would be about it is? What if they purposely left him out to DLC Pack 2? And they're like, oh man, we just pulling y'all dicks. You know what I mean? Like, nah, what if they put him in DLC Pack 3? I'm a pissing they cereal for that.
My gripe with this is, like, why in the world? Okay. They literally have every other, like, with DLC Pack 2, they will literally have every playable GT character from every, like, from all the games combined in the game, except for Baby. And the baby that's in here isn't even playable. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Man. It's stupid. Stupid.
So
yeah,
if they don't do this, I don't care what Dimps has done in the past, I will never forgive them from this. This is just... It's unacceptable. Like, there's no other word for it. It's unacceptable.
I mean, we put up with most of the stuff they've been doing. They're being pretty lazy. Like, me and Platinum, we have access to the DLC Pack 1, the first half anyway. Why the fuck is there a variant of GT or Kid Goku from Dragon Ball in GT clothes without a tail who can also go Super Saiyan? What the fuck? What the fuck is that?
Must I say, it's a copy of Goten, but with just they made him, you know, a little bit more tan and stuff like that, and they gave him Goku's face. That's all it is. I mean, and he has a shitty voice, worse than Kid Gohan from Kai. Can I just say a BS for that? Because I mean, overall, no, that's pretty much it. Overall, I mean, I can't wait for the DLC Pack number 2 to come out, but I really do doubt that Baby will be in it, unfortunately, and. I don't see him being in there because pretty much with this DLC pack and with pretty much the dialogue, pretty much how this all goes down is essentially kind of a spoiler here. Pretty much what happens in the first fight is where I think you fight Noah Shenron when he's controlled by Demigra, then you fight Ice Shenron who's controlled by Demigra, and then you fight you fight Omega Shenron who's controlled by Demigra, and pretty much you fight along with Super Saiyan 4 Goku and Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta. But the ending of the game, which is kind of the ending of a DLC pack, must I say, or the ending of the GT saga, it pretty much has you where you have to fight Grade 8 Baby Demigra control, pretty much all the GT villains, Omega Shenron, Super Android 17, and Baby, all pretty much you have to fight all three of them at once. Now, I wasn't really that surprised about that, but that's one of those little things that I just don't like about that. I mean, are you guys hyped about it? Because I'm not.
Not really, because like Platinum said, then again, this is a DBZ game. This isn't going to have some fucking amazing story, but here we go again with the wormhole thing, and I realized they could be using a different wormhole or whatever, but one got destroyed, so where the fuck did the other wormhole come from?
Exactly.
So it's like, okay, whatever.
Yeah, whatever is right. So, is there anything else you have to say before we, you know, kind of take it out and all that kind of stuff right there?
One more thing I want to say is, fuck the GT story. There's I was watching Sergio's video earlier, and I swear to God, there's like three lines of dialogue, and I'm just like, okay.
No, dude.
I had to walk a block of.
There's the Nappa Force. The Nappa Force, man.
I don't care about the Neo
Ninu, the Ninu Force. Ninu Force, though.
Dude, Black Super Saiyan is not finished. Don't judge it. No, it's fucking.
Well, you know what, Platinum? I understand it's not finished, but you know, sometimes you can actually put the dialogue in. I mean, it only takes a few lines of code, like right there and right there. Even though, you know, they didn't put it in, so they're kind of easy a little bit. You know what I'm saying?
If they don't have Super Baby, then I other than like special occasions, like special things, I don't see myself playing this after DLC Pack 2 that much. If they don't have Baby in the game, because I can't enjoy the game to the fullest without some of my favorite characters. It's bad enough I'm missing like characters such as Janemba, but I can I got over them. Yep. Because they're not the only game Janemba's been in from Dimps is the Infinite World, and Cooler's been in Budokai 3 only. I think was he in 2?
No, I don't think so.
Japanese release, but he wasn't even a character, like a skin for Frieza.
Okay, well he was only in 3 in Infinite World, so I can understand them not putting him in because Dimps.
I can't.
Well, especially because they fucking acknowledge him inadvertently while you're training under Goku, which is stupid as hell.
Again, I'll put my video in the description below, but DBZ God doesn't have to because it's irrelevant on his channel. But
Wait, what? I thought we were talking about telling
you not to promote me. But I'll put mine in the description because I mentioned that, and it's actually some sketchy stuff. But because Dimps, if they don't do this, I can't forgive them. I don't care what they've done in the past, what good games they made. If they do this, that's some scummy shit. So, yeah. That's all I can say.
Alrighty, so anyway, guys.
Let me take it out. Let me take it out.
Alright.
Go ahead and do your thing. I'm taking it out.
Alright, you take it out. No, you want to go for it? You go for it.
Okay. I want to take it out? Okay. End it after this. I'm about to spit some bars.
Alrighty, so anyway, guys. Wait, you're going in. Oh my god. You're doing it, guys.
I'm not about to spit no bars. All I want to say is, I hate all y'all. Peace out.
Peace, guys.
Peace.
See you guys later.